Hey guys, welcome to Restless Outdoors. It's tent testing time.
Yes, guys, it is true. Outdoor Vitals has sent the Restless One yet another piece of gear to review. Obviously, for my last review, it didn't go so well. But I promise this time, we're gonna hit a grand slam. So what they sent me was their Outdoor Vitals one-person Dominion tent. Now, I personally have never slept in a one-person tent, so I'm very excited about this. What I'm gonna do is take you guys over, kind of give it a first look, and I'm gonna get in it tonight and sleep in it and kind of give you a full report the next morning. Now, quick disclaimer, I've never owned a one-person tent. I've always utilized two-person tents, so this is actually gonna be a first for me. But I do have someone here that has actually used a one-person tent, and we're going to get his take on this tent, seeing that he slept in a one-person tent out backpacking. And of course, we have none other than Timmy from Restless Outdoors. Hello, Timmy.
What's going on, guys?
So you've actually slept in a one-person tent before, correct?
Yes, I have. The first tent I ever owned was a Midori Solo. It's a Eureka tent. Weighs about 5 pounds, so kind of heavy tent for being a one-person tent.
So with that said, guys, I'm going to have Timmy actually get in here and kind of compare the Midori Solo to this tent.
All right, first thing I see is that there's plenty of space in here. It's wide for the arms. I'm not a small guy. The Midori Solo was very constricting. I had to put my arms straight down at the sides here. You have some room to kind of open yourself up a little bit and have plenty of room head to toe, plenty of room over your face is very good. The biggest issue that I had with the Midori Solo was the headroom. So when I'd sit up, my head would push through the top of the tent. But in this one, there's plenty of room, and I have a little bit of room right above me where the whole tent isn't moving as I'm trying to move around in it like I'm wearing it like a jacket. There's plenty of room left to right, head to toe, front to back. So it's very spacious and wide for a one-man tent.
And also, too, just to note, we are using the X-Therm sleeping mattress, and that's in a large. And you can actually see that it does fit in there pretty good. It doesn't show that the sides are bulging or anything like that. It does have bathtub floors, which is really nice. And what we'll do now is kind of show how the vestibule works in this thing.
There's a steep angle here, but there's a lot of room. Oh, you can get your shoes all the way out to the edge, but still keep them dry. Put your pack right here, and then you can still cook and do things right in front of you. With the Midori Solo, there wasn't a lot of room here, and there was not a lot of room to cook and then keep your stuff also there. So I had to kind of put my stuff outside, cook and have my dinner, and then go and pull everything back in. And at the first time I used this, it actually rained that night, so I had to put my pack outside in the rain and then cook and then bring everything back in and try to dry it out somewhat.
So this tent here with this vestibule space, you definitely have a lot more room.
Absolutely.
Okay, so compared to the Midori Solo that Tim did use, and I've seen that tent personally, this is a little bit larger. I'd almost call this a 1.5, although it's not a 1.5. It definitely is a one person, but having that large vestibule, I'd say, is definitely a plus, because a lot of these one person tents, that's where they're lacking, is the vestibule space. Setting up this tent too is a very easy task. You actually have just one pole that all connects. The nice thing about this one too, you do have a brow pole that comes over the entrance, and I'd say it's probably maybe about 3 inches overhang, which is extremely nice, especially if you do get a little bit light rain, you can actually keep this open. But again, setting up this tent, very simple. It's no different than any other freestanding tent that's out there. So as you guys know, I have my three famous criteria when choosing products, especially with the tent. So the first one is the ease of setup. As I explained before, the setup was very, very simple. Again, no different from any other freestanding tent. My second criteria is comfort. Now, what I'm gonna do tonight is actually sleep in this thing for the very first time. Never slept in a one-person tent. So in the morning, I'll give you my full report. And of course, last but not least, is the durability. And well, we all know what that means. Okay, so I'm inside the Outdoor Vitals Dominion one-person tent. Again, this is going to be the very first time I'm going to sleep in a one-person tent, so I'm very excited. It's about 10 o'clock at night. As you can see, I'm sitting up in here, which is pretty cool, especially on an air mattress, so it is definitely doable. But I will give you a full report in the morning, and see how this baby performs. So, good night. Good morning. I have to say, I am pleasantly surprised at how comfortable this tent was last night. Plenty of room. Ventilation was, I guess, okay. There was really no wind, obviously, to speak of, but I slept just fine in here with both of the vestibule doors open. There was absolutely no issue. Space-wise, it was fine. One thing that surprised me about this tent is I like to sleep with my camera gear in the tent, and actually there is enough room here in the foot area, even with the mattress in here, to fit that in. So the fact that I'm able to sit up and drink my coffee is a huge factor. All in all, again, just pleasantly surprised at this tent. I would say, you know, if you're looking for a one-person tent on the inexpensive side, but something that's fairly lightweight, again, 2 pounds, 14 ounces, $200, and you get a footprint, I wouldn't see why you wouldn't consider this tent. Now, obviously, it didn't rain, so I can't speak of the waterproofness, but everything looks seam sealed, everything looks proper, so I don't foresee any problem with that. But yeah, kind of shocked. So what are my final thoughts on the Outdoors Vital Dominion one-person tent? Well, obviously with my three criteria, ease of setup, super simple, comfort, I was pretty comfortable last night. I'm telling you, for $199, it's pretty hard to pass up this tent, especially when it comes with the ground sheet and the fact that it weighs 2 pounds, 14 ounces. Guys, unless you want to spend $300-$400 on a tent that weighs just a little bit less for one person, honestly, I really think this is the way to go. But before I end this, obviously, part of my three criteria that we did not touch upon is the durability factor. So let's get to it.
Holy shit! Thanks, Outdoor Vitals. Love ya.